I want to ask you about Matt Mendenhall, right? Now he was not a
Yeah.
pro, right? He was an amateur bodybuilder. You've competed against him, I think, a few times. He was not a pro, but he left quite a legacy, right? How would you, what do you think about him as a bodybuilder and also the legacy that he left on the sport?
Probably the most talented guys that ever lived. When I go a little bit, I tell a little bit about the competition, why I ended up in America already in the early age. In 1982, I won the European Championship, being a junior, and I won the heavyweight show, in the senior competition. The only one who ever did that was like Arnold Schwarzenegger still. But for that reason, I already had attention from America. So Ed Connors at the time invited me in 1983, when I was 21, to stay in his house. He always has been like a kind of a scout. He always had a good eye for talented bodybuilders. And that same summer, Matt Mendenhall was invited. So we actually trained for months together, and besides that everybody could tell that he was so gifted, he was not only the most gifted, talented guy, he was also like the nicest guy you ever meet.
Why he didn't become pro, do you know?
I think condition that kind of hurted him. It was never really the shredded condition, and I think maybe, if I even tell that about myself, if I knew back then what I know now, I could have been better, and that's same for Matt. I think that if Matt Mendenhall showed up back in the days 100%, he could have won everything, including the Mr. Olympia.
Wow, that's incredible. Now, is it true that you got suspended at one point? What happened exactly?
That's a story too. In that was in 1992 when the WBF came, and there's a story to that. In 1988, I
WBF is
turned
what exactly?
WBF is the World Bodybuilding Federation. It was like owned and like founded by Vince McMahon,
All
the
right. Okay.
owner.
Yeah.
Yeah. So at one point he said, "Well, if I can make a sport like wrestling this famous and that big, I will do the same thing with bodybuilding." The reason that I made that this decision, because a year earlier, after my third place at Olympia, I had a pec tear. And maybe we will speak about it a little bit later down this interview. But because of that, I never really believed in my challenge and in my Olympia dream anymore. And I was kind of lost. But the reason that I was actually the first guy that was suspended was also because it's the, okay, I'm doing this interview on my phone, just I get some message sometime. The reason that I was suspended, the first guy, and officially, was also because I was the only one and first guy who explained to Joe and really why I did
Wait, so
it.
I just want to understand it correctly. So the WBF came on the scene and you started competing for them, right?
Yes.
And then did you have to leave the IBB Pro or you still stayed in both?
No, that's of course really important what you are asking, because no, that was the case. Because once you were leaving the IFBB, you were not allowed to compete like in any other federation. You were suspended. So, and because I explained why I left, because of my whole story, I was officially also the first one who was suspended. I also have to add to that I'm also The first one who was back in the IVB, and I think I was the only one who got like a sponsor contract with Joe again, Joe Weider. And once I asked him, I said, Joe, why are you giving me this contract again after that they did this to you? And the only thing he ever said is, if a lost son comes back to his father, he welcomes him with open arms. So, and he never ever said anything else to that.